Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Carburetor, the show dedicated to cars and motorcycles. Today we launch a new column, though, called Carburetor News. In it, I will try to briefly present to you everything that happens on the world automotive scene. Without further ado, let's get started. Although the decline in sales of new cars is more than 50%, in the last month there has been a slight improvement in these values. Given the unusual situation, the outcome and development of which are not clear to most of us, many people choose to buy a car for one simple reason – to travel in isolation. In fact, many others avoid any travel and rely on easy and individual transport such as bicycles, electric scooters and the like, which I believe will have an extraordinary boom in 2020 and 2021. During this COVID madness, BMW will have between 5 and 6,000 job cuts in the most delicate way possible, through early retirement of employees and other staff-friendly approaches. The situation is similar at Nissan, where, due to the melting demand of their cars, they take precautions and they apply reduction of the work shifts. The American manufacturer of electric cars Tesla plans to soon build their second factory in the United States. Approximately 5,000 new jobs will be created there, and Tesla will add even more percentages to its already proper development strategy. The international automotive giant Fiat Chrysler and the French PSA group Peugeot and Citroën will be deeply investigated by the European Commission after their merger. This is because with this combination, they will become the fourth largest car manufacturer. And this could lead to a risk for one of the main European light truck producers. The German car manufacturer Volkswagen was also not spared by the status quo and had big losses in China and America, but the management still plans to fulfill its annual plan through very good cost discipline. These were the words of the company's CFO Frank Dieter during an internal meeting with the company's manager. All the cataclysms and challenges that we've talked about concern not only the big car manufacturers, but also ourselves. We all need to adjust to the situation and to move on to possibly brighter times in the future. That was all for today's short and first edition of Carburetor News, dear friends. From me, Nico, beware and be friendlier to the other participants in the street, especially those in America. Bye for now and take care. Peace.